songs on the radio.
See Bleeding Ear.
Playing them loud like in the studio.
Hello, 7.1 WJBB, Bleeding Ear, Part 2 with Hunter Flanagan joining us this morning. Hunter, we were just talking before we get to our studio cut today. You are from the Alabama-Georgia line there somewhere.
Yes,
and
sir.
You have a pet possum.
Yeah.
How did that happen?
A friend of ours, a possum got killed, I think by a dog that was around their house or something. And they didn't even think of it. They were trying to get rid of it, and they checked the pouch, just questioning, and there were two live possums. And they kept one, and we kept one. Same family, the guy that original song is going to be played earlier, or
yeah,
later is going to be
right
about. And we kept one, and now it's been a good few months. He's about big. I'm realizing I'm on radio. He's, you know.
Facebook Live saw it.
Fairly,
bigger than a bread box.
Good size, yeah. And what is it like to have a pet possum? Are they family friendly? Are they?
Oh, yeah.
Because it's a wild animal.
I don't know if it's because we got him so young or just because they're real sweet, but he's really, I mean, he uses the litter box. He's completely sweet.
Really?
He follows me around.
Sleeps with you.
He does sleep with me. He comes with
his
name.
Are they cuddlers, or what kind of a sleeping mate is a possum?
They're cuddlers.
Cuddle.
You wake up, and you'll have, like, a tail wrapped around
your
arm.
Oh, no.
And their tail has no hair.
So
it feels like you're sleeping with a Burmese python or something.
Rude is kind of used to having tail wrapped around him, but not of that variety.
Oh, hey, now.
Leg locks.
And it's usually got hair on it.
Anywho.
What's the name of the possum?
His name is Crowley.
Crowley. For Mr. Crowley, the Ozzy Osbourne song, or where'd you come up with the name?
No, I'm a huge Neil Gaiman fan. Neil Gaiman.
Okay.
And I love the book Good Omens.
Oh, okay. So you're a reader.
I am, yeah.
Wow, that's a rare breed these days.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, people don't read like they used to, do they?
No, they don't. I think by now I've read everything Stephen King's ever written.
Wow.
But I'm a huge horror nut and stuff like that.
Yeah, me too. Well, we're gonna play something from this is a studio cut. Do you have an album out?
I don't. I'm working getting some songs recorded right now.
Right.
I got about five or six that need to be get recorded.
If folks would like to either come see you or pick up some of your music, where can they do that?
All right. So I do have some shows that are coming up that I was told to.
You have lots of shows coming up.
I do, but these are the big ones.
Okay.
These are the ones I want people to see me.
Okay, all right.
but you can find all my information. I'm Hunter Flanagan, F-L-A-N-A-G-A-N. A lot of A's, a lot of N's, no I's. You put an I in my name, you might find a singer. He might be named Hunter, but it's not going to help me because it ain't going to be me. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, all that stuff, and I got a website, thehunterflanagan.com, spelled the exact same way.
Okay, all right, fair enough.
And I got some big shows coming up. I have 221 at Brew House in Rome, Georgia for the All-Star Country Concert. 312, I'm back on Atlanta & Company for Brain Injury Awareness. I'm going to be singing the song I sang here there. 313, I'm at the Ritz in Toccoa. That show I'm booked actually with Greg Irwin. I know he was on here a couple weeks ago.
Love Greg Irwin.
Oh, yeah.
Cool guy. You know what's funny? We had Greg Irwin on the show. And, you know, we like to do a little interviewing before, you know, a little conversation before the guy plays. Conversate, as Tim Rose likes to say. He didn't really, he was sort of a man of few words. So then he did his song, and then we wrap things up, we take some pictures, you know, that kind of thing. And then we couldn't stop him from talking.
Yeah, once you get to know Greg, like I told y'all, I met Greg Irwin. We were trying to find my first PA system to start singing. And one of my promoters, they said, oh, ask this guy. He knows everything there is to know about this kind of stuff. So we sent him a text, and he said, yeah, can you just call me? And I said, sure. 3 hours later, I said,
wow.
I remember going, okay, so it's the Fishman 330. You can get the 220 or the 330. They're both amazing, man. But
goodness.
But another thing.
Best conversation I ever had, and we call each other, like, at least once a week. I mean, when we're heading to shows and stuff, he's great to talk to.
Well,
I mean,
the folks at WJBB said hello, and we look forward to having him back on. We got a big kick out of him.
So, got a couple other shows. 327, I'm at Gatlinburg Brewing, and 530, I'm at, also with Greg Irwin, at the Gravel and Grit Fireflies and Picks in Claremont, Georgia. All the ticket sales for all these shows are on Eventbrite.
Okay, fair enough. All right, tell us about the song. The one we're going to play.
All right, the one we're going to play. This is a love song, and it started like all love songs start out. I met a man in a bar. that sounded...
I met a man in a bar last night.
That sounded worse in my head. But no, he's a real good friend of ours. We actually met him at a campground. We're practically family now. He's a Brett Strickland.
So this was a stranger that you met who I'm guessing turned out to be a particularly colorful kind of guy.
Yeah.
Made an impression on you.
Oh yeah, we're practically family now. He owns a repair shop in Noonan, Georgia.
Yeah.
And we call him my mechanic because he always fixes my car because I have a Land Rover that constantly needs work.
Well, it's British. It's a British show.
Exactly. Yeah. And it is expensive. No, but he's a great kind of guy. He offers up wisdom and whiskey if you want that kind of thing.
Usually they go together pretty well.
Usually, all yeah. Right. But he loved music and he really liked hearing me sing and we just really hit it off and absolutely love the man. But most of the things in this song is played up for the comedic value, but most of these things are things that he has said, at least in a joking manner, at
okay.
some point
all right.
in the fact that I've known in the time that I've known him.
All right, what's the name of the song?
The song is called Complex Man.
Complex Man. This is Hunter Flanagan, Bleeding Ear, 107.1 WJBB.
1, 2, 3, go!
People always tell me I'm a very loving guy. Reckon it has something to do with this big old heart of mine. You know I'm a complex individual, I'm truly one of a kind. Sit back, relax, I'm gonna lay down the facts about everything that crosses my mind. Gotta love the football game on Sunday afternoon, and I might wager on it, just a paycheck or two. And I love the horses that race on down the line. Love to watch trot and gallop and win or lose. Well, it gets me every time. I'm not ashamed to say I'm a very emotional guy. And this next one here never ceases to bring a tear to my eye. You know I'm a complex individual, I'm truly one of a kind. So sit back, relax, I'm gonna lay down the facts about this next little vice of mine. I love a nice cold beer after a hard day, or 6 or 7 or 8 or 9, who's counting anyway? Nothing beats a glass of whiskey around closing time, or anything in a glass bottle, be it scotch, tequila, or wine. They find out about these other loves of mine. You know I'm a complex individual, I'm truly one of a kind. You got to sit back, relax, cause I'll lay down the facts about what made my exes whine. I love the women of every shape and size. Once they smile at me, I'm done every single time. And I love loving, hugging and kissing too. Girl puts her arms around me, oh, every time I'm through. People always tell me I'm a very loving guy. Reckon it has something to do with this big old heart of mine.
.1 WJBB, The Bleeding Ear. That's Hunter Flanagan with Complex Man. Liked it, man. Thank you for coming in this morning.
Thank y'all for having me. This was a lot of fun.
Continued success, man. I hope you make it to the big time and we can ride your coattails wherever you end up.
That's right. I already friended you to ensure that.
So you, Blake, you don't miss a lick. He hasn't even left the building yet.
I would do that because I'll forget when they leave the building.
Well, think of us when you're there in the mansion and you're looking for somebody to come over and hang with. We'll be right there.
Right, and we'll bring our own possum.
All right, I'll think of y'all as long as it's okay whether I end up in a mansion or a cardboard box. Either way, I'll think.
All right. All
doesn't
right.
matter.
Just don't call if you end up in the cardboard box. All
right. Better off in a pine box. I want to hear you sing that one. Oh, that old Doug Stone hit. That remember song, that?
Yeah. I've been better off in a pine box on a slow train back to Georgia.
How about Tim finally hit the notes on that one? That was good, Tim.
There you go.
You're in your element there. Maybe that's it. We need to get you to come on and sing some country music.
There you go.
All right. Hunter Flanagan joining us here on 107.1 WJBB. Charles Locke, pleasure as always.